everyone, I Nidhi from Plus 2B Science welcomes you to the episode 3rd of Coffee with Alunchit. Today, we have Arshpreet Kaur as our guest.
Thank you, Nidhi. I feel immense pleasure to be the part of this series.
So, Arshpreet, you are in 12th standard, last stage of schooling, right?
Yes, this is the last stage of schooling and I'm really excited for my class 12th as well as for my board exams and have already started preparing for it.
That's great. We need to pay more attention and work really hard this year. Well, tell me that how was your percentage in class plus one?
Well, my score in class 11th, it was pretty good, but I think I need to do more hard work to achieve more in class 12th board exams.
Yes, of course, and I truly believe that you will do it.
Yes, of course I will.
Well, tell me about your future goals.
Well, my future goal is to join the aviation industry and I want to explore the world.
That's really cool, but make sure that you don't crash the planes.
No, I will not crash the planes.
Well, Arshpreet, you know what I thought?
Yes, please tell me.
I thought that you will be answering me that you will be going to abroad in order to pursue your higher education.
No, not at all. I don't want to move abroad for my higher education. Why would one move there if here in India only we have many better opportunities? Well, why did you think so?
Actually, this opinion is there among a lot of students. Many students have such kind of opinion, that's why.
Yes, I have also seen that many students prefer to go abroad and they want to study there.
This is called brain drain.
Well, what's brain drain?
Brain drain is a process of migration of the young and talented youth from one country to another. Basically, it happens from the countries which are in a developing stage to the countries which are already developed.
You know, Nidhi, the people of India, they are renowned for their hardworking attitude and entrepreneurial spirit. And over the years, they have made significant contribution to India's economy. But what do you think that why people want to move to abroad only?
That's the question. I think most of the people move to abroad in order to raise their standard of living and also get more money.
Yes, I think one of the main reasons is the lack of economic opportunities here in India. That's why they are moving abroad in search of better job opportunities.
That's right. Economic factors like peer pressure, political instability, safety and security continue to play a major role in this.
Yes, Nidhi, not only here in Punjab, in many other states as well, students prefer to move abroad. They take normal diploma or a course and they do part-time jobs to pay for their fees. Trust me, I have seen this scenario. Some of my cousins and relatives, they are in Canada doing the same thing, which is for the PR, you know, again because of high standard of living, right?
That's right. You know who is the chief minister of Punjab?
You're talking about Mr. Bhagwant Mann, right?
I thought that you will be answering me Narendra Modi.
No, it's not like that. I'm really good at general knowledge.
That's good. Recently, he addressed many students at Maharaja Ranjit Singh Punjab Technical University in Bhatinda.
Yes, I have seen that. He promised that he will stop brain drain in Punjab. He also said that the state government is committed to create new opportunities so that our youth does not go to foreign shores in pursuit of their dreams. He also remarked that soon people from foreign countries will come here in Punjab to work.
I really hope that foreigners do approach to Punjab in order to seek jobs.
Yes, then instead of eating salads, they will be eating paranthas and they will get more healthier just like Punjabi.
But before that, we need to set our houses in order. The law should be maintained, the corruption should be abolished and also there should be a control over the committing suicides by the indebted farmers and labourers.
Yes, you know the universities of India, they produce doctorate holders and specialists, but our youth likes to do IELTS. And instead of getting prestigious degrees, they want to score 7 bands in that. And they want to earn their living in abroad.
I think people should not leave India. As in India as well, there are many scope, especially related to IT sector.
Yes, Nidhi, I agree with you. In cities like Gurugram, Pune, Mumbai, Bangalore, Chennai, there are high chances that you can get good placement packages. And eventually you end up saving a lot of money, maybe up to 1 lakh rupees per month.
That's right. I think generally people think that if they'll move to abroad, then they will be saving a lot of money, but they are unaware about the dark reality. In real, the expenditure in the outside world is very much higher and the salaries are not that much.
Yes, Nidhi, absolutely right. This is the sad reality. And moreover, in India, there are many educational institutes which provide quality education with excellent placement packages.
Can you name few of them?
Yes, colleges like IITs in Madras, Bombay, Kanpur, Kharagpur and Delhi. They provide excellent placement packages along with high-paying jobs in various sectors like IT sector, engineering and manufacturing and consulting also, and there are many more. And NITs are there, BITS Pilani is there, Delhi Technological University is also there doing the same thing.
Also, the government has launched several schemes for that. Do you know any of them?
Well, I'm unable to recall, so can you please tell me about that?
Yes. Schemes like Pradhan Mantri Rozgar Yojana, Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana, Prime Minister Employment Generation Program, etc. provide skill, assistance and training to the young youth so that they can set up their own enterprise and become good entrepreneurs.
Yes, Nidhi. Moving abroad can be really very expensive and not everyone has that financial means to relocate, right? And especially considering the visa fees, travel expenses, food expenses and of course the cost of living in a new country, right?
Yeah. This problem is literally the talk of the town. I think the movies are being produced on the concept of brain drain. Have you heard about the movie named as Dunkin?
Yes, I know about that movie. That movie is totally based on the concept that people are choosing unfair and illegal means to move to abroad and this costs their lives too. Trust me, this gives nothing. It gives the insecurity and instability. Even after hard struggle, if they will reach their destinations, their families, they all are left alone, right?
Yes. I think the youth need to understand that they are the supporting pillars for their own family and as well as the country. So instead of going out, they should be there only in India and should pursue higher education here only so that they can become a good businessman.
Yes, Nidhi, I agree with you.
Even I gained a lot of information from you as well, Arshvi. Thank you so much for being on the show.
Thank you, Nidhi. I also had a very great time talking to you.
So this was all for today, but we'll be meeting you in the next episode of Coffee with Olonsiate. Till then, stay tuned with Olons International School.